Campus police say a student has died from a self-inflicted gunshot wound inside a dorm.
And the bomb squad arrived on the scene to deal with some explosive devices that were found. This investigation is happening in Tower 1. That's at Knights Plaza. WESH 2's Marina Morocco is live on the campus right now with all the breaking details. Marina.
That's right, Jason. And in the last hour, students here have been receiving a lot of text messaging from the school. Now, they were complaining that they hadn't received any kind of alert as to what the situation was and what was going on. That last text message, take a look on your screen, coming in at about 4:40, reporting that suspicious device being found inside one of the dorms while they were investigating a suspicious death. Now, those students still not inside that dorm. They're still, that dorm still evacuated. And they're still waiting to go back in.
Skyping my girlfriend doing homework and just went off. Figured it was probably too late to be another drill.
It appeared to be just another Monday night at Tower 1 when sophomore Jason Smith says he heard the fire alarm go off and knew something was up.
The police had like AK-47s and they had guns out, so I figured either an intruder or something. There's cops speeding in and out.
UCF police received a call at around midnight from Tower 1 reporting a suspicious incident. When they showed up, they evacuated the 500-bed dorm and the adjacent parking garage G.
The victim of what appeared to be a self-inflicted gunshot wound. Upon further investigation of the residence hall, the police found an assault weapon and what appeared to be improvised explosive devices. That's why the tower remains evacuated and the garage is evacuated as well.
Now, police won't say whether the suicide victim was a student nor who made that initial call to police. Students here telling me that it's a very diverse dorm hall, anywhere from freshmen to graduate students living in this 500-bed dorm. For now, reporting live at UCF, Marina Morocco, WESH 2 News.